This video is one of the most requested on my channel ever, so I'm happy to give it to you. Today we are talking about how I edit my YouTube videos. When I first started YouTube, I spent so much time editing my videos. It took days to edit a 10 to 15 minute YouTube video. So over time, I realized this is not working, so I got much more efficient at it, and now I can edit my videos in just a few hours. Before I get started, I want to ask you the question of the day, which is, how long does it take you to edit your YouTube videos? Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe for more YouTube tips on how to grow your YouTube channel. Now with that, let's jump into the editing. Now I will say, full disclosure, currently now I do have a video editor. Hello. But there are some videos that I still edit, and when I do edit, I use this process so that way I can do it quickly. I'm a mom of 3 kids. They are 4, 2, and 2 months old, so my time is incredibly precious, valuable. It's so precious to me. I have no time to do anything. So when I do have to edit my YouTube videos, I want to make sure that I'm quick, I get in, I get out, boom, we're done. By the way, if you're interested in hiring a video editor, you should check out this video right here where I talk all about the process. Now, the very first step in editing my YouTube videos is I upload my footage to my camera. And I have a system in my computer where I have all of my YouTube videos organized. So I'm gonna create a folder for that specific video, and then I'm gonna create a subfolder for the raw files. So this includes all of the video files from my camera, but also the audio files from my microphone. And on top of that, I have specific folders for things that I commonly need and use. So I have one all for sounds, I have one all for images, and then even within there, I have subcategories of GIFs, of emojis, of logos, things that I constantly would be using in my YouTube videos, or if I've even used it in a YouTube video one time, I will save it into these folders so that way it's handy when I need it. Video files take up a ton of space, so I don't want to be editing and then have my computer run out of memory when I'm in the middle of editing, so that's why I store everything on here. And if you're interested in checking this out, I will include a link down below of the one that I use or another one that I highly recommend. So after everything is uploaded and ready to go, that is when I hop into my editing software, and I use Adobe Premiere Pro. When I first started out, I used iMovie and it was great, but there are some limitations, and so once I was ready to really level up my editing, that's when I moved over to Premiere Pro. There was definitely a little bit of a learning curve, but if you're familiar with iMovie, you can fumble your way through Adobe Premiere Pro, or you can find a few quick tutorials online that will show you how things are set up. And that's what I did, and then I got more and more familiar with the program every single time that I used it. In Adobe Premiere, I create a project specifically for that YouTube video that I'm making. I upload the files, and then I open up another project, and this contains the master files for all of the elements that I use typically in my videos. So this includes text, sound, special effects, anything that I frequently use in my videos, I just have it in a separate project so that way I can easily copy and paste it into this project, because I found that I was wasting a ton of time having to either recreate this different text effect every single time or having to go and find a particular sound that I use. And so for that reason, I just keep it in that special project and I switch back and forth between the two whenever I need it. So then the very first thing that I do when I'm editing my YouTube videos is I'm going to upload my footage and I'm going to sync the audio. After I've synced the footage, then I color correct the footage. I like to do this at the very beginning, mostly because my footage is not changing. I'm not outside, I'm not vlogging, so it's not super complicated. I really have just 1 or 2 video files that I recorded, so my color correcting is very simple. It's not even, I don't even think a professional video editor would call it color correcting. Basically, I just tweak the exposure, the highlights, and the blacks, and really that's it. So at this point, I am ready to get down and dirty and to start editing the video. And this is where I use my process that I developed called the RFR method. I teach this way in depth in my course, the Vid Boss Academy, but what RFR stands for is rough cut, fine cut, and then review cut. And really what this means is I get to look at my footage 3 different times. And the first phase, I am doing a rough cut. The second phase, I am doing a fine cut. And the third phase, I am doing a final review of the footage. The reason I implemented this is because I found that when I was editing, I would edit maybe a minute's worth of footage and then I would go back and I would watch the footage again. And this was just such a time suck. One of the biggest time sucks that you will have in editing your YouTube videos is going back and watching the footage and re-watching the footage. So with this method, I cut all of that out. You're really only watching your footage 3 times through. So it's pretty simple. With the rough cut, basically I'm just going through and I'm cutting out all of the unnecessary flubs and mess ups. I'm finding my final version of the lines that I wanna say. So I'll watch the footage, I'll do a cut on what I need to keep and then delete everything that doesn't. And then I'll keep watching, I'll do a cut and then I'll delete the footage that is not needed. And I go and I do that for the entire video. Once I'm done with all of the rough cuts, then I will go and delete all of the spaces in between and it shrinks the file down. And now I'm ready for phase 2 of the RFR editing method, which is the And then I'm ready for phase 2 of the RFR editing method, which is the fine cut. So this is where I go through with a fine tooth comb and add all of those different elements that I need. Some videos I go way over the top. I'm adding all sorts of graphics, text, sound effects, all the bells and whistles. And other times for other videos, I'll do my edits more simply. But either way, whether you're going all out or you're just doing very simple edits, this is your opportunity where you can go in and add all of those other bells and whistles. And the way that I do this is I do this one clip at a time. Since I've already cut it up into little clips, I just take each of those individual clips as an opportunity to add the different things that I need. So usually at the beginning of my YouTube videos, I'll have to add a subscribe animation because I want to remind people to subscribe. Or at the beginning, I'll add a little Instagram icon with my name and have that throughout the whole video. Or I'll add some title cards, some text, some sound effects. And I do that one-on-one for every single clip. Some clips may be longer because I didn't mess up and they're a longer clip. And so I go and I add everything I need to add for that whole clip. And I do it all here. Basically, this is my only opportunity to add those things. And yes, I do go back and watch this particular clip just to make sure that the timing is right and things are popping up at the right time. But I'm not going back and watching previous segments. Then once this clip is done, I put my seal of approval on it and I move on to the next clip. And then I add everything that I need to there. And then I add the next clip and the next clip. So I repeat doing these fine cuts all the way until the very end of the footage. And then, and only then, do I go into phase 3, which is the review phase. This is the final phase where now you're able to go and watch it from start to finish. And the idea and the goal here is that you are gonna watch it from start to finish and hopefully you won't have to stop and fix things. Hopefully in phase 2, that is where you caught all of the mistakes and you added everything that you needed to add, but you may find in this final review edit that there are some things that are out of place or that you missed. So if you find things like that that need to be edited, no worries, go ahead, stop, edit them, and then push play and keep going. Don't go back to the very beginning and watch from the beginning because again, every single time that you do that, you're just going to add more time to your editing time. So hopefully this final phase of the RFR editing method is the fastest and the quickest because there really isn't that much for you to do. So then once you watch everything and you get to the very end, this is where you are basically done editing and you need to export the video. I already have my export settings loaded up and ready to go. So all I have to do is rename my file and then hit export.
A few minutes later.
Once the final version is exported, this is where I go and I do one last review of the video to make sure that everything exported correctly and that it looks good. I don't know why, but randomly, sometimes it will just export without sound for some reason or half of your graphics are gone. So during this very final review, this is where I'm just watching to make sure that everything is okay. And I'm also taking notes of things that I want to include when uploading the YouTube video. So if there's any end cards that I mention or info screens that I need to add, or I mention a different product or resource, I take notes of each one of these and the timestamps. So that way when I'm uploading my YouTube video, I have all of this handy and ready to go. And it's really just plug and play. Another thing that I take note of during this final review of the video is my monetization ad breaks. So the mid-roll ad breaks that appear in the middle of the YouTube videos. You can manually place these in your YouTube videos. And I have a YouTube video right here that talks about that whole entire process. Or you can let YouTube choose where they want them to go. I like to pick it myself, so I write down the times that I want my ad breaks to appear during this final review. So once I've watched that video and everything looks good, then the editing process is officially done. It's a wrap. And I move on to the next process, which is uploading the video to YouTube. So there you have it. That is how I edit my YouTube videos and how I can do it very quickly in just a few hours instead of a few days. Now, before you go, you'll want to check out this video right here where I talk about hiring a video editor. So whether you love editing or you don't love editing, this video will be very helpful for you to figure out whether you're ready to hire a video editor for your channel. That's all that I have for today, and I'll see you next time. And the idea is, baby, sometimes until everything is... Baby. Baby refuses to sleep today, so this is really throwing me off my groove. But we'll keep going. All right.